Well, hello. You were a fool to have come here, but while you're visiting, let's talk about maps. Everyone loves maps. Map games, map painting. And the most common map you'll see is this one here, the one of Earth, I guess. But not everyone likes playing on this same old map all the time, through different eras, all on the same map. I wish I knew why this one was so common. I'll never be able to understand. And I wouldn't say that map modding is difficult. It's difficult to learn, for sure, and it's time-consuming, but it's nothing crazy and technical. You don't need any programming or artistic skills to make it. If you're already experienced with HoiFor modding, it probably would only take a day or a couple of days to figure out. But alas, only a fraction of people who get into modding take the leap to making custom maps with custom provinces and custom states. And while completely understandable, it is a shame. There's a lot of ideas I've seen over the year, like, you know, Old World Blues, more simple Fallout North America map, or stuff way out there like the GTA map for the broken GTA mod. And then there's the topic of today's video, the Metro mod. This mod takes us to a post-apocalyptic Moscow based on the game and the book. And it's an amazing, beautiful map, I would say. The intricacy of the design, well, I don't know if I'd say intricacy, but the uniqueness is only surpassed by, like, space mods. Yeah, space mods are weird. And they use a design similar to this, but instead of subway tunnels, they're hyperspace lanes. Those maps are weird. I don't know what to think about HoiFor in space. Doesn't work well. Play Stellaris. Except some of them look pretty cool, just saying. So, you know, maybe not play Stellaris all the time. But this mod in particular, since it's not in space, reminds me a lot of another mod. Not a HoiFor mod, but an EU4 mod, Anbanar. It's not a Metro EU4 mod, don't get me wrong, but it is a fantasy mod that includes an underground section ruled by dwarves. I'm sure Anbanar didn't invent this underground areas in Paradox Games concept, but this mod is how I fell in love with the design. It's such a nice way to let the player know that it's an underground area. It just is very fitting, and it's very unique for a Paradox game. You don't see terrain like that. And of course, in real life scenarios, you're not gonna have massive underground areas on an Earth-sized map. But if you know, you go to the Moscow Metro, or you are looking at a fantasy world with dwarfs, then it makes a lot more sense. Unfortunately, the dwarf thing is in EU4, and it works well there because of how the combat works, but it doesn't really translate into HoiFor, because HoiFor combat is very different. The tile-by-tile design doesn't work very well. If you're attacking from one tile into one other tile, it gives the defender a massive advantage, and that's not how HoiFor combat is designed, so it's not going to be fun. But to fix this, they have changed the way tunnels are broken down so that there's one main column and then two small side provinces, allowing you to still have the multiple directions of attack. So it fixes the issue in a beautiful way that makes the map look better at the same time, instead of just having simple chunks or rectangles or something that would look kind of, you know, gross with provinces. And this mod is integrated so well into 1.11. It's a subway. And so, of course, trains make sense. And I have to assume they started making this mod after the 1.11 release due to just how perfect this idea is for the new update. It just fits so perfectly with trains. I have to guess this is a product of No Step Back releasing. But if it is a coincidence, that's also a pretty amazing. It just makes me so happy. It's beyond perfect. Unfortunately, the feeling goes both ways. In some mods, the railway system doesn't make a lot of sense, and you can mod and change what trains are, of course, but it is kind of a pain. I guess it's not as much of a pain as changing the entire tank designer system to be something else. Yeah, trust me, I've been trying to do that recently for a mod I'm working on, and it's not fun. Well, it's fun, but it's fun in a very weird way that I don't like. And this mod is an alpha, so there's not very much here. It looks like a really big mod, but there's not that much added yet. I can't critique it because it's just an alpha. A lot of mods will release an alpha and then never actually release. But yeah, it's fine. I like to see unfinished mods rather than mods that never have an alpha at all. So I'll take what I can get. Everything is designed in a very unique way so that we have military access through intersecting rails. So like, we are the red line, but then we have access through anything that the red line intersects just so that we can connect to our other areas without being trapped or having supply issues. But then that does obviously cause issues if you want to go to war with one of these countries you have military access with, which is weird. I don't know exactly how that will work or if the mods even got to that state yet. We'll be playing as the Red Line, who aren't a main character in the game or the book, but they exist and they're nice, you know, communist nation. Our main enemy will be the Fourth Reich. They're the only country with a focus tree, but the focus tree is small enough and the vanilla focus tree is good enough that it doesn't really matter if you play as the country that has a focus tree or not. I personally think it'll be more interesting defending against them rather than playing as them, so we will see what happens. So I really do like this hub and tunnel design. I feel like there should be more provinces in the tunnels, maybe like for this one 6 subsections or this one 4, but I haven't done any combat yet, so I don't know if that's very necessary. And with how many hubs there are, there's a lot of space to fight through, and it's a very linear fight. It's not like a regular Hoi 4 combat. Of course, there will be multiple fronts, but it's a very different situation. So it's interesting. Some of the advisors are a little overpowered. Like, our Minister of Propaganda gives us 0.3% weekly stability, which, when reading out the number, that doesn't sound like very much, but that is a lot of stability. And most advisors that give weekly stability at most would give 0.1% weekly. Because if you think about it, 0.3% weekly stability will, in the long run, end up being 15% stability a year, I believe. So it'll add up really, really fast. The unique tech tree is also very nice. There isn't much in it. A lot of the tabs are gone, rightfully so. You're not gonna have a navy or nukes in the subway. Oh, but that would be interesting, setting a nuke off in the subway. It'd of course destroy everything here, but it's okay. And I love our tiny little trains here. It's also fun watching the divisions stare at each other from across the tunnel. So now we'll attack the most resource-rich area on the map, Polis, the center here, and we'll get to see what combat is like. I've added some flamethrowers to my divisions, but really haven't done much else. Then I put recon. Yeah, there's recon in here too, but it just looks like it's broken, but it's working. Don't worry. We also have a terrible disintegrating military law that we can't get rid of until, let's see, I think it's 2032. Yeah, so I don't know if the Fourth Reich will declare on us before or after that point, but if they declare on us before that's gone, then we are going to be kind of weak. But once we take all these resources, that might make up for it a little bit. Yeah, or maybe we're not gonna be taking it. We'll see. We seem kind of weak here. Well, so I realized the mutinies in the army, national spirit, gives us a minus 33% reinforce rate, which means that we can't actually reinforce battles. That's kind of annoying. You might think it's just decreasing the reinforce rate by 33%, but I believe the reinforce rate starts below that 33%, so we have like a negative reinforce rate, so we're never going to be able to reinforce a battle. So yeah, we really don't have any chance here. But yeah, we'll get rid of that national spirit in about 5 more months, so we'll just have to hold on for a while. Yeah, now with that terrible national spirit gone, it's going to be incredibly easy to break these guys. It's pretty much free now with having reinforce rate. Reinforce rate might not seem like the most important thing, but it does a lot. And it also appears that the Fourth Reich has been in a war with a neighboring country for a long time. They seem rather weak, or maybe the AI isn't properly calibrated for the mod yet, so they're unable to do anything. So yeah, it's gonna be quite the easy invasion, but we'll take them out. We'll finish the job. Anyways, very interesting mod. I do look forward to what it may implement in the future, though, if we're being honest, Toy 4 mods that releases an alpha very rarely are ever fully released. Usually devs give up on their mods far before they're finished, but this is at least an interesting concept. If more comes from it, I will look forward to that. Anyways, I guess I will see you all next time.